Hello you guys, welcome back to Plus Size Kimonica's channel. Okay, in this video I just want to share something with you guys. The title of this video will be six things that have changed since I've lost 100 pounds. I've lost more than 100 pounds now, but these things I saw when I lost 100 pounds. When I lost 100 pounds, I noticed these things and I was just like, oh, that's awesome. So I just want to share this with you guys. So I have them written down. And so let's get started. So it's six different things. My mom wanted me to add one of them. So it was five different things, but my mom wanted me to add one, so I had to change the video to six different things. And it's more than just these particular things that I'm pointing out that has changed. But these are just things that I really wanted to mention to you guys. And just in case you guys were wondering, this look I did because Eyes Love Makeup Channel is something else to her name. She asked that we redo looks that she do and submit pictures to her, and so she can put them in her video, stuff like that. So that's why I did this look. I know y'all like, wow, y'all have never seen nothing like this on me. And I really don't like it. I don't think really bright colors look right on me, but whatever. It was fun. Anyway, so this is not in no particular order. No one thing means more to me than the other. It's just, I'm just going to name them. One thing. Something that I was really embarrassed about at my heaviest is when I got in the car, right? The steering wheel sat in my lap. And it touched my belly. Now, I don't mean to the point where I couldn't drive. It's just that it touched my thighs and it touched my belly. And I knew that if I got bigger, then I wouldn't be able to drive my own car. You understand what I'm saying? So, yeah. Now, you guys, oh, I do not have that problem. I feel so awesome, you guys, not for my stomach and my thighs to touch the steering wheel. You know, for me to look like I'm in a tuna can, I'm squinched up in the car like this trying to drive. You know, that feels so awesome. Like, I don't have that problem anymore at all. And that I feel so great about that. So, I have a lot of room now. A lot room. Even, you know what, even when I pushed the seat all the way back, my stomach and my thigh was still touching the steering wheel. But now, I don't have to push the seat back all the way to drive. Matter of fact, now I have to pull the seat up a little bit in order to drive. And my stomach does not touch the steering wheel nor my thighs, so I'm really excited about that. Okay, another thing, I can walk a mile, you guys. Now, if you've been following my journey, that is one thing that really, really mattered to me. Like, I can walk a mile now and not get tired and not be in pain. I can walk a mile. I can remember where I can walk maybe 5 minutes and my back would start hurting. Now I can walk a mile and not be tired. That is awesome. That is so awesome. Another thing, I do not get headaches anymore. I used to be like the poster child for Excedrin migraine, and I thought it was just me. I got headaches, but no, it was the bad, unhealthy foods that I was eating. I would go through like a 24-pack of Excedrin maybe every 2 to 3 weeks. I would get headaches maybe every other day. I would wake up with like terrible, terrible headaches, and I just thought, you know, some people get migraines. Oh man, I started my weight loss journey on July the 4th, and since July the 4th, I've probably went through one pack of the 24 Excedrin migraine. One pack. One. Do y'all understand how awesome that is? And now the only reason why I take it is because, you know, when my friend come around, you know, you get headaches that time of month. That's the only time I might get a headache now. So, oh man, that is awesome. That's awesome. Okay, the next thing. I've been like cleaning out my closet, cleaning out, throwing away shoes I don't want, throwing away clothes I don't want. And I've been trying on clothes that I haven't worn in years. Years, because I was too heavy for them. And I'm able to fit a lot of clothes that I have not worn in years. Years. And that feels so, 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 so awesome, you guys. It feels so awesome. The next thing, my mom wanted me to include this. My mom, she's like, when she used to hug me, she tried to put her arm around me, but like her fingers would touch, you know, just like this. So she couldn't wrap her whole arms around me. But now she can wrap her whole arms around me and touch her wrist like this. And I think like she's so excited about that. She's like, oh my God, I can hug my baby all the way and I can touch my hands. So yeah, she wanted me to include that one. So she's really happy about that. And the last thing, I don't live to eat anymore. I eat to live. And that is so, so important. So important. I can remember when I used to get so excited. Like, I know this is silly. I know this is silly, but I'm going to share it with you guys. When my mom used to go grocery shopping, I used to get so excited. Like, she'll come home, you know, at night or whatever with all the new groceries, the new cereal, the new cookies, and all that great stuff. And I used to be so excited. You know, it was a rule. You can't eat cereal in the evening. You have to eat them in breakfast time. So I used to get so excited. I used to, like, hurry up and go to sleep so I can wake up the next morning and eat. You know what I'm saying? So eat my favorite cereal and... oh man, and I couldn't wait till the next meal, till that food digest, so that I can eat again, you know. Oh. And then when I was old enough to buy my own food, I used to just eat because it was there. Eat because I wanted it. Eat because it was my favorite cake, you know. Just eat, eat, eat. So I lived to eat, you know. That's all I thought about. I lived to eat. So now, you guys, I eat to live. And I'm so excited about that. Food does not excite me anymore. And I'm really, really excited about that. I'm really excited about that. I don't think about food like that anymore. I eat when I get hungry. And when I get full, I stop eating. You know, I forget to eat now. So I just want to share that with you guys. Six things that has changed since I've lost 100 pounds, and I cannot wait until I lose 200 pounds to share with you guys what has changed since I've lost 200 pounds. I'm really excited about these six things, you guys. I really, really am. So I hope you guys enjoy. Thank you guys so very much for coming to Plus Size Kimonica's channel. I love you guys. Peace.